Hey everybody, welcome back to A Better Computer. My name is Matt, and today I want to show you what I've been doing at work recently to try to keep on top of all the things I need to track, whether they be big strategic things, projects I need to work on, tactical stuff that comes up day to day, just what I said I would do today, what I said yesterday. Just trying to keep track of all that is just very challenging at times, and I found something that's really helped me recently and wanted to share it. So I'm going to show you what I do at the end of the day to give you a taste for kind of what I'm doing, and then we'll go into the details of how things are set up. Just to be clear, this is all test data. This is on my personal computer, not my work computer. My work computer has all data that I cannot show you. But this is all kind of just like placeholder stuff that'll give you the idea. So I am using Obsidian to view my stuff, and I'm using Claude code to adjust it. On my work computer, I use Cursor, but again, the details don't specifically matter. Let's just do what I do at the end of the day. So I will typically bring up dictation on my computer and just start talking. All right, I am finishing up the day, so I'd like to archive the tasks that I did today. Anything I didn't do can be backlogged. We'll do that later. And then go through my daily notes and find what I need to do tomorrow. Go through my meeting notes to find what I should do tomorrow. And definitely at the top of the to-do list for tomorrow, I need to talk to Marcus about that video on the Affinity suite of apps. That's a really important thing to me, so put that at the top. So there we go. It's gone ahead and dictated that for me. I'm just going to submit, give it edit access, and now you can see it's reading my to-do list, my daily files, it's going through my meetings and other things that I have, and we should see in Obsidian in a second. These to-dos will be removed. We have new ones here, and there we go. And we have the priority, talk to Marcus about Affinity Suite for Apps video project. Cool. So it's going ahead and doing some more stuff here, but you can kind of see basically what I've done is made it so that when I come in tomorrow, here are the things that I thought were important based on the meetings I had today, based on the things that I put in my daily notes, and the things that I just kind of said at the end, like things that were top of mind. And I find it helpful just to talk this through. Talking it through to yourself is helpful, but then having it spit out kind of versions of this are really, really nice. And so basically, I can get rid of Claude at this point. We can just stick with Obsidian. For those who don't know, Obsidian is just a way to look at files on your computer. This is all just a view of the video file on my desktop. You can kind of see, I'll hide the invisible files. Notes, series roadmaps, to-dos, right? Like it's just, they're just files. And so what this has done basically is that tomorrow morning, I can just open my computer, I'll see this, and here are the things I said I would do today, and I can start churning through them. If I go through the daily notes, you'll see I have this kind of fresh slate where I can start to put things. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I can see my backlog here. These are all the things that I said I would do later. Some of these were things we just put off from the to-do list we already had. Here's an archive of what I completed with due dates on all of, or the dates that I completed them on all of them. Here's my daily notes archive. This is really cool. Basically, The concept of this structure for me is basically I have two main files I'm working in most of the time. I have my to-dos. These are just the things that I want to do today. These are not long-term things. This isn't a full project management thing or anything. It's just for me tracking what I need to do right now. So these are the things I said I would do today. That's fine. And then the daily note, this is where I will typically copy something and paste it in here. And it's not going to look pretty. It's just going to be a message from Slack, an email, something. Like, it'll just be things that I want to know and remember and just have access to, like, have them in text that says, I encountered this text on this day. And so I basically put these all in here. If we go to the Daily Notes archive, you can get an idea for this. The stuff we just archived was from November 3rd, and here's all the things I had here, and it just kind of blops them in here. When we archive the next day, it'll go below this on the list as well. So this is searchable. This is understandable by the LLM that I'm using to kind of sort things, to rearrange things. But yeah, there's some other stuff in here. You can have like project files. You can create text files with projects you're working on. Notes are really important. I find this really helpful. I can put some information on specific people you work with. Meeting notes are huge. I am in a lot of meetings, so remembering what we talked about, who we talked about it with, what was said. This is really important. So again, these are just fake meeting notes. But basically, I am almost always using something to get a transcript and a summary of what we talked about. And I'm saving that immediately after the call finishes. I'm copying the summary or the transcript. I'm creating a new note in here. I have a template set up, whatever, but like I just call it like a one-on-one with Marcus. And then I would just paste my notes, right? I would just paste the meeting notes here. And the way that I do them with, I use Granola often to do this, which gives me a list of who I was with, the time, the name in the meeting. Really nice. Works really well and has a really generous free option, which I'm actually still using. So that's cool. But I just paste that here and it's all searchable. Again, research is here, projects, whatever, assets, series templates. When I'm creating a new series or whatever, you can have a template for files. So as an example, let's actually go to Ghosty again. Make a new project file for something about Affinity Studio apps, right? And so this is going to be not great, right? It's not going to be very detailed because we're not giving it much information, but it is going to go ahead and take this series template and it's going to create an affinity suite. And so here it is. And it's you know, it's done the LLM thing where it fills out a bunch of info, but you don't have to do that. When I have done these in the past, I do use a template and then I have it create these files for me. But I'm dictating to my computer for like 5 to 10 minutes sometimes, giving it tons of context for what I want. And then it kind of, I kind of just like ramble. And then it does a pretty good job of sorting it into the structure that I need, finding the key details. And then I go through it and I start editing and changing things and rewriting a lot of it. But having something to edit is a lot easier than having just a blank page staring back at you. So I find this really helpful for kind of starting projects like that. You definitely don't want to just give, like just push the slop to production or to whoever you're giving this to. But yeah, I do find it helpful to get something on the page. Then I have a Fire folder where I put like customers who are on fire right now and need really quite a bit of attention. I'll put notes here so I can just kind of like remind myself what's going on here very quickly. But most of the time I'm doing the rest of my work and then I'll kind of make it smaller now. Like this is more like what it normally is. You know, I just have, here's my to-do list. Whenever I need to have a free moment to like do something, I go through here and be like, okay, what can I knock off the list? Let's do this. I got this, this and this. Great. And then it's just a text file. So it's easy enough to add things to different categories. You can just, again, it's text. You can delete it. It's not as good as a dedicated task manager or whatever, but like, it's pretty good. And the daily note and stuff. But I think the thing that makes it really convenient is like, if at the end of the day, I had to cut these and paste them into the archive, that would be a real pain. Whereas right now I can just say, archive my completed tasks, right? Just do that. And I don't typically do this in the middle of the day. You don't really need to do that. But like, I don't need to move them. I just told the computer to do it and it did it in a couple seconds. And that's very, very nice. So yeah, this is the general idea for what I'm doing here. Let me know if you're interested in this. I may do a deeper dive into exactly what's going on here, but it's helped me. This idea of having this to-dos and this daily file, again, sometimes I'll even have them side by side, maybe make it a little bigger, and so I can kind of see my notes and my to-do list at the same time, right? Do I even need the file system over here? Maybe I could shrink that down, right? Like you can get creative with it. Obsidian is hugely customizable, but yeah, it's working in text is liberating. So I don't know if I'll do this forever, but right now it's really helped me just, again, wrap my hands around what I have going on, what I'm responsible for. And yeah, maybe this will, this wasn't like a full tutorial or anything, but maybe it'll give you some ideas for how you could maybe use text files to manage the stuff you're working on. And yeah, use LLMs to help you sort it, to generate things, to keep things up to date. Oh, I didn't even mention a critical thing here is this Claude file. So I have told Claude, basically reference this, this is what tells it how this whole thing works. So when I say mark my to-do, my archive my to-dos, it knows that the key files are to-dos, which is a central action tracking for these items, and notes archive is where things get, or not daily notes, to-do archive is where they're moved from to-dos.md for reference when they're completed. I have a backlog one for backlogging. So all the structures here, you can use the LLM to help you build this file. But yeah, this kind of started with literally just a to-do list and meeting notes, and I've kind of grown from there with this sort of information. Again, this is all placeholder, but yeah, let me know if this is helpful, if you'd like to see more of a deep dive as to how I'm using this longer term. But yeah, that'd be interesting to share. So there you go. Have a good day. Bye-bye.